Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in financial accounting. And in this video, we're going to dive into the effect that LIFO has on a company's financial statements. We'll start things off by answering the question to, what is LIFO? Next, we'll talk about the implications to using this cost flow assumption and some alternatives that exist. Finally, we'll discuss the impact that LIFO has on the financial reporting of a business. Understanding how LIFO works is crucial for both accountants and the business as a whole. So let's dive right in. Imagine you owned a company that sold merchandise. Every time you made a sale, in order to determine whether you were profitable or not, you would need a way to efficiently track how much you originally spent on that inventory. However, what if you sold thousands of different products and were constantly reordering inventory at many different points throughout the year? It would be extremely difficult to trace back the original cost of each piece of inventory every time a sale was made. Companies that sell inventory need a more efficient and cost-effective way to assign value and monitor the inventory's physical flow. This is why many organizations choose to use cost flow assumptions as an inventory valuation method, with LIFO being one of the most common. However, depending on the method they choose, there can be significant implications to the financial statements. So let's dive into what LIFO is and how it works. LIFO stands for Last In, First Out, and is an inventory valuation technique that companies use to track both their inventory and cost of goods sold. Under this cost flow assumption, it's assumed that the inventory that has come in last is the inventory that is sold first. For example, let's say a company buys inventory at 3 points throughout the month of March. On March 25th, they make their first sale of the month, selling 8 units of inventory. Under the last in, first out method, they'll assume that all 8 units sold were from the last batch of purchases on March 20th. When companies make a sale, they record the cost of that sale, or the cost of goods sold, at that time. So another way of thinking about this is that the costs associated with that March 20th purchase are the first cost to be removed from the inventory value and reported on the income statement as the cost of goods sold. This also means that the older costs are the ones that remained in the company's inventory balance on their balance sheet. If the company wasn't using a cost flow assumption, for each of the 8 units sold, they would have had to specifically identify the cost of each piece of inventory by physically tracing each item to one of the 3 batches to determine the cost. However, in this case, we're in luck. Since they're using last in, first out, they can assume that all 8 units came from the last March 20th batch and would therefore each have a cost of $48 associated with it. This $48 value is important because this is the amount recorded to the income statement as the cost of goods sold for each piece of inventory on that sale. This allows for an efficient way to track the company's inventory value and profitability in an effective manner. We can now easily calculate the profit on the sale of each piece of inventory. Assume we sold each product for $78. The $78 sales price less the $48 cost of goods sold would equal a $30 profit on each piece of inventory. There's various cost flow assumptions that companies can choose to use, such as LIFO, FIFO, or weighted average. And depending on the choice, there could be impact to the company's bottom line profitability. Now that we understand how LIFO works, let's talk about a common misconception. The goal with cost flow assumptions is that companies choose the one that most accurately aligns with the flow of their inventory sales. So for a company that sells perishable goods like fruit and vegetables, it's likely that their older inventory will be sold first. If that's the case, it would generally be more reasonable for them to select FIFO or first in, first out. However, companies don't always choose the method that matches up directly with the physical flow of their inventory. It's important to remember that these are just cost flow assumptions, meaning that the physical flow of costs can be different from the actual flow of the physical inventory units. This means that just because a company is using the LIFO method to track their costs, doesn't mean they necessarily have to sell their newest inventory first. So why would a company choose to use LIFO if they're usually selling their older items first? Wouldn't it make more sense for them to use FIFO? This is likely because choosing to use LIFO will have an impact on the company's financial statements. LIFO generally results in companies reporting less profit on their income statement. But why would companies want to show less profit? Well, this is because it may save them money on their income taxes. LIFO became popular due to inflation and the fact that income tax rules in some countries allow companies to use this method. By assuming the more recent higher-priced inventory is being sold first, a company records a higher cost of goods sold expense, which decreases profit and can reduce the amount of income taxes the company has to pay. If we take a look at the example from earlier, we see that the price of inventory is slowly rising throughout the year due to either inflation or other market factors. Since this company is using LIFO, they're able to match their recent, more inflated costs of $48 per unit with their sales, thereby reporting less taxable income than would occur using FIFO. Under LIFO, their profit would be $30 per unit. However, under FIFO, they would be required to use the $40 inventory rate for their cost of goods sold expense, which would lead to a profit of $38. We can see that using LIFO would likely result in less tax being paid, since there's less profit being reflected by each sale. Since the higher value goods are being removed from inventory first, LIFO also usually leads to a lower inventory value on the company's balance sheet. This could possibly mislead the users of the financial statements. As a result, some regulatory bodies require that companies make a note of this in the financial statements to provide users with a more accurate picture. Companies are able to justify using LIFO because matching the latest costs with the latest sales revenues is a better indicator of the company's current profitability. And that brings us to the end of this video. LIFO is a commonly used cost flow assumption that gives companies the ability to efficiently manage their inventory and cost of goods sold. Whether you're a student, investor, or business owner, it's important to understand how LIFO and other cost flow assumptions work, as they can have a major impact to a company's financial statements. Now, while we just skimmed the surface here in this video, if you're interested in learning more, please feel free to check out our additional videos on many more related topics.